出生缺陷是胎儿在宫内生长期间发生的结构异常或功能异常，其中最严重的包括心脏缺陷、神经管缺陷和唐氏综合症。出生缺陷同时也指是婴儿出生前发生的身体结构、功能或代谢异常，是导致早期流产、死胎、婴幼儿死亡和先天残疾的主要原因。出生缺陷病种多，病因复杂，目前已知的出生缺陷超过8000种，基因突变等遗传因素和环境因素均可导致出生缺陷的发生。出生缺陷将严重影响胎儿的生存和生活质量，给患儿及家庭带来巨大的痛苦和经济负担。出生缺陷是可能由单基因缺陷、染色体异常、多因子遗传、环境导致基因子、微量营养素缺乏引起的各种先天性疾病。在中低收入国家，孕产妇患梅毒和风疹等传染病是导致出生缺陷的一个主要原因，而在发达国家，出生缺陷也早已成为婴儿死亡的第一位原因。随着医疗技术的发展和卫生保健水平的提高，出生缺陷患儿的生存率不断提高。国际研究显示，出生缺陷儿中约30%在5岁前死亡，40%为终身残疾。孕产妇患糖尿病、碘和叶酸缺乏症，接触包括酒精和烟草在内的成瘾物质、某些环境化合物以及高剂量辐射，是导致某些出生缺陷的其他因素。
We know that most birth defects develop during the first weeks of pregnancy.Which is critically important to recognize because that means that planning for a pregnancy and taking steps before pregnancy is incredibly important for primary prevention. Unfortunately, we also know that not all birth defects can be prevented, but we do know that there are some actions that can be taken before pregnancy to increase a woman's chance of having a healthy baby. For example, two of the most important ones are quitting smoking and taking a folate supplement.It is something that we have known for a while. It is something that we have communicated widely. It's something that many of us have heard. And although it may seem obvious to many of us, we know that still 1 out of 10 women still smoke sometime during pregnancy. We know that some medications can cause birth defects, and we are working to determine which alternatives might be safer to use during pregnancy.It's not only about personal choices that individual women can make in order to prevent birth defects. We have begun to identify some critical and common environmental exposures that increase women's risk of having a child born with a birth defect. And further, we are seeking to better understand other less common but equally impactful exposures.
据悉，预防生育缺陷的措施可划分为3个等级。一级防御措施是在孕前和孕早期采取的措施，以预防出生缺陷的发生。主要内容包括健康教育、婚前医学检查、孕前优生检查、增补叶酸等。适龄妇女在选择最佳生育年龄的同时，应避免接触放射线和有毒有害物质，注意孕期合理营养，预防感染，谨慎用药，戒烟戒酒，消除可能引发生产缺陷的因素，避免出生缺陷的发生。为了预防胎儿患有出生缺陷，准备结婚的男女双方应当主动接受婚前医学检查等婚前保健服务。婚前医学检查不同于常规的健康检查，男女双方应当在结婚登记前主动到医疗机构接受婚前医学检查、卫生指导和健康咨询等婚前保健服务，重点针对严重遗传性疾病、指定传染病、有关精神病以及其他影响婚育的疾病进行咨询、检查和指导。二级防御是指采取医学手段，对适龄妇女孕期进行产前超声检查、产前筛查和诊断，以及及时发现胎儿是否存在出生缺陷，避免严重出生缺陷的胎儿出生。三级预防措施是在新生儿出生后对新生儿疾病进行筛查，以早期发现应治疗的新生儿疾病和异常。同时开展孕前保障，在刚怀孕时和怀孕初期确保妇女及其伴侣最佳的生理和心理健康，以增强正常妊娠和婴儿健康的可能性， 最大限度减轻出生缺陷的危害，提高患儿的生活质量。世界卫生大会于2010年通过了有关出生缺陷的决议，其后在12个组织的支持下，世界各地在2015年首次纪念了第一个世界出生缺陷日。随着人们对出生缺陷越来越重视，建立专门的机构来预防和诊断治疗先天缺陷已是刻不容缓。在这样的情况下，新生儿护理中心横空出世，不仅弥补了医疗空缺，也解决了广大家长们的燃眉之急。
据了解，1%-3%的孕妇会在妊娠期面临复杂的胎儿异常情况，其中许多新生儿出生后就需要立即接受手术治疗，否则就可能会有生命危险。然而在普通医院，医生通常会因种种原因无法对胎儿的情况向家属进行详细的解释，家属也会因问题得不到解答而感到无助。新生儿护理中心的出现恰巧弥补了这样一个医疗空缺。新生儿护理中心重点面向因胎儿带有复杂先天症状而经历高风险孕期的父母，它像是一个专门为母婴搭建的延展平台，可以在胎儿被检测到异常后为这些胎儿提供详细准确的病情诊断，同时支持孕妇及孕妇家属，为他们提供咨询辅导和进一步的治疗建议。
So the fetal center is very different from other places in that we really focus on a family-centered approach to our care. We involve the mom, her partner, anybody else who's in the family, in the actual plan of care. And so they actually get a say in what happens with their pregnancy. And this is different because in our center,We really want the mom and her family to have a say in what happens. So when a mom comes in, when she sees her regular OB doctor, who is usually who refers patients to our center, she is usually told by her OB doctor that there's a problem with the baby. And then she's referred to our center. And on the day when she comes in, she's able to have all of her diagnostic testing done on the same day, and that can include a fetal MRI, an OB ultrasound, a fetal echo, and then she has the opportunity to meet with all the specialists that may care for her and her baby. So we truly focus on mom, her baby, while involving the family in the care. You know, we get our patients in really quickly. Once we get the referral from the patient's referring provider, we see that patient within 1 to 7 days.We understand that a new mom who's experiencing complications doesn't want to wait to come in and see her provider. She wants to know right away what is going on with her baby and to help have a plan. And so we don't make the mom wait a long time to come in. We bring them in right away. And when she gets here, she'll be greeted by our wonderful staff in a calming environment. We'll bring her back to her room right away. She'll have likely an ultrasound and or a fetal echo right here in our space, and then have the opportunity to meet with her nurse coordinator, either myself or one of our other amazing nursing team leaders. And she'll be brought back and explained everything every step of the way. So there's no question about what's going on. The nurse coordinators are fantastic about providing the education that's needed so that the mom and her partner and her family can understand the diagnosis with the baby and walk out of here knowing a good plan of care is in place.
Peter Yu 是城县儿童医院的总医师，也是新生儿综合护理中心的联系医疗主任。他毕业于乔治霍普金斯大学，有多年的临床经验。在他眼里，新生儿护理中心与普通医院有着十分大的不同。
My name is Dr. Peter Yu. I'm a pediatric general and thoracic surgeon at Chalk Children's and at UCI Health. And I am a co-director of the Fetal Care Center of Southern California.
We are a one-stop care center for pregnant moms whose babies have congenital anomalies. In other words, serious birth defects that will need treatment after delivery and perhaps even treatment before delivery.
To this point,If you're a family who's been diagnosed with a birth defect and your baby is unborn, oftentimes you're left without help. This center provides all of the specialists under one roof that can answer your questions and confirm the diagnosis.
新生儿护理中心通常会配有 胎儿护理、新生儿科、小儿心脏病、妇产科、母婴医学以及高危险妊娠方面的权威专家医师。当胎儿在产检中被检测到有异常情况后，他们可以在第一时间分析诊断母婴病情，设计治疗方案，并给出专业的治疗意见和孕期所需的产前干预，以确保孕妇与胎儿的健康，让产妇可以安全生产。这些专业医师也可以应对在护理中心发生的突发状况，保证孕妇和腹中胎儿的生命安全。
The great news is that in our office, we have maternal fetal medicine specialists. These MFMs are also known as high-risk OBs, and so they are fully prepared to take care of any emergency. Most likely what we'll do is send that mom to one of our partner institutions for obstetric care. There are many things that the fetal care center can provide, but the bottom line, the one message that I would like for families in our region to know is that we are here for you. We can take care of your baby. You can put all of your burden, all of your anxiety, all of your concerns on us. We can take care of the full spectrum of problems, and we will see you and your family through from start to finish.
产检对于正在怀孕的准妈妈们是孕期必不可少的一环。这不仅仅是因为产检可以检测出胎儿的性别和发育情况，还是因为产检是唯一一种可以检测出胎儿是否患有先天性缺陷的途径。如果胎儿患有先天性疾病却没有被及时发现并得到干预，那么无论是对于胎儿自身还是家属来说，这无疑都是一个致命打击，甚至可能会从此改变一整个家庭的命运。
My name is Dr. Jennifer Jolly. I'm a maternal fetal medicine specialist within the Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology at UCI Health. One of the standard ultrasound exams during the course of a pregnancy happens between about 18 to 22 weeks gestation, and that would be ordered by a mother's primary care provider. If there's an abnormality suspected for the fetus at the time of that exam, the mother would be informed of that difference that is noted and ideally referred to the fetal center for further imaging, confirmation of diagnosis, and a full spectrum of counseling regarding the finding. Mothers receiving a diagnosis of a fetal birth or a fetal an abnormality or congenital anomaly go through a full wave of different emotions at the time. The distress can be minimal in the setting of a small abnormality that won't have any clinical significance for the baby, but it can also be life-changing and life-altering. We, as maternal fetal medicine specialists, support the mother and the family through that time of diagnosis and information gathering. And at the fetal center in particular, the mother and the family will be able to have their questions answered. Because when a diagnosis is made for, an unexpected diagnosis is made for a fetus, that family's life changes and so many questions arise. The fetal center is designed to be able to answer those questions all in one place and all at one time. 3% of all pregnancies are complicated by a birth defect. And as a maternal fetal medicine specialist, when a birth defect is identified in an otherwise low-risk patient, they're referred to our office for confirmation and counseling. We see the full spectrum of fetal abnormalities. There are structural abnormalities of different organ systems, such as the brain. There is a spectrum of open neural tube defects, such as spina bifida. Defects in the diaphragm that can cause life-threatening abnormalities in lung development, such as congenital diaphragmatic hernia. There are other problems with the abdominal wall where organs that are typically inside the abdominal cavity are actually on the outside of the baby. All different organ systems are addressed during the course of an anatomy evaluation in utero, and all different organ systems and abnormalities in those systems would be addressed, cared for, and have the full spectrum of counseling here at the fetal center.
如果你的宝宝患有先天性疾病，请不要自责。与遗传性疾病不同， 先天性疾病是一种绝对偶然的现象，孕妇和孕妇家属是无法做任何事情来规避或降低这种情况的发生概率。
The reality is the majority of birth defects happen by chance. There's nothing that a family, or in particular the mother, could do to predict or prevent this from happening. So at the time of diagnosis, in almost all cases, this is a surprise for a family. But we need to reassure the family that it is not their fault. There's not anything that would indicate an abnormality other than the diagnosis at the time of the imaging. And so I don't have any advice for families in terms of what to look out for, but we certainly have advice and comfort and support for families after an abnormality is identified.
据了解，心脏疾病是最常见的先天缺陷，约占各种先天畸形的28%。在2013年，全球有3430万人患此疾病。根据调查状况，先天性心脏病每千名活产新生儿大约可影响4至75人，而大约每千名活产新生儿内有6至19人可能有轻微至严重的病情。妮塔·都什是就任于这间护理中心的小儿心脏病学医学博士，毕业于加州大学欧文医学院，同时也是城县儿童医院的一名儿科医生，专注研究于救治患有心脏衰竭和肺动脉高压的儿童患者。他认为，先天性心脏病作为世界上最常见的先天性疾病，家长应当给予相对的重视，以避免不必要的悲剧。
My name is Nitha Doshi, and I am the Director of Fetal Cardiology here at CHOC. Congenital heart disease is so important, and many people don't know that it's actually the most common congenital abnormality in the entire world. And we know that 1 in every 100 babies is born with a congenital heart defect, and unfortunately, it remains the number one reason that a baby would pass away if a congenital heart defect were not to be detected. You know, with the advancement of ultrasound technology, we now have the ability to really carefully evaluate the baby's heart as early as actually 16 or 18 weeks in the pregnancy. And so that would be the time in which we could actually identify whether or not the heart has formed normally and to take steps to help to monitor that heart over the course of the pregnancy to help the baby deliver in a center that's most appropriate for that condition and for any immediate therapies the baby may need after birth. So we have the opportunity as early as 18 weeks in the pregnancy to identify any change or difference with the way that the heart formed. Some of the heart conditions that we identify are minor and simple, and other heart conditions that we identified are much more complicated, and some can actually be life-threatening. So we treat the entire spectrum, all the way from minor to very complicated types of heart conditions. These can include conditions like holes in the heart, they can include narrowing of valves or narrowing of arteries, and important changes that once the baby is born and enters the world out of the mother's womb can have an impact on the baby's health and safety. We can then be there to actually stabilize the baby right away from having actually identified that problem before the baby was born and really help that baby to have a great outcome.
So I'm super excited to share with families that the Fetal Care Center is especially designed all the way from its very first cell to be able to provide every single resource necessary. So not just excellent diagnosis and not just excellent counseling and options for therapeutic intervention in the future, but every resource that comes along with the multidisciplinary aspect of taking care of that family up until birth.
实际上，先天性心脏病虽听起来骇人，但并不如大家想象的那么可怕。很多先天性心脏病在婴幼儿时期病情发展十分迅速，不过只要发现得早，及时进行手术治疗，就很有可能治愈，让患儿像健康儿童一样茁壮成长。妮塔·都什也说，只要尽早地检测出胎儿患有先天性心脏病，就可以在婴儿出生后着手治疗，做好万全的保障措施，确保婴儿健康。
So currently, actually, across the entire nation, approximately 60 to 70% of significant congenital heart disease is missed. And that's even in our realm of exceptional technology. And so much of that has to do with the opportunity that we have as providers to actually impart the education to improve prenatal detection. Our goal in the fetal cardiology world is actually to achieve diagnosis prenatally of 100% of significant heart disease.
新生儿护理中心对于准父母来说，无疑是一个让他们可以更加准确清晰地知道胎儿病情的平台。他们的疑问不仅将在新生儿护理中心得到解答，而且因为护理中心采用的是专家会诊的方式诊断病情，他们将有更多的时间与专家医师接触，免去了重复排队的等待时间，让胎儿的病情可以尽早得到确认，也为孕妇和孕妇家属提供更方便安心的医疗服务。
您正在收看的是凤凰卫视。